So what will happen to you if you follow the lunation cycle, the eight phases of the moon? You'll be surprised. Actually, you are following the lunation cycle each and every day of your life. You just are not aware of it. It's so natural to us to follow the lunation cycle that we don't think about it. But once you think about it and you're aware, you'll be surprised how on time and with the energy you will become, because it's so natural to us human to follow the moon. So let's start. The first phase is the new moon phase. And what does that mean? Every month we have a new moon. And it's when the transiting moon is actually aligning with the sun. If this is the sun, the moon transits and it comes to the sun and they meet. They are in the same degree, in the same astrological sign. That's a new moon. We have it every month. And a new moon is about a new beginning. It will depend in which astrological sign the new moon is occurring. That will color what kind, what type of energy is coming forth. But new moon is a new moon. It's an unconscious energy that is being born again. The lunation cycle takes about 29 days, and the moon would take about 2.5 to 3 days in each astrological sign. When the new moon meets the sun, they create a new opportunity, a new way. Something new is coming out, but it's unconscious. We don't know what it is yet. It's just an energy. It's a primal energy. If we compare it to a seed, it's when the seed is germinating underneath the ground into darkness, shooting that first root, and it's not knowing. It's actually shooting its energy forward, and we don't know what kind of a tree that will become yet. Same thing with the new moon. In that particular moment in time, we can set an intention, but we don't really know how it will unfold. So this is every new moon. The energy would change with every sign. So if we have a new moon in Aries, it will be all about action and projecting ourselves, me. If it will be in Taurus, it will be maybe about things that we would like to have, about financial security, in Gemini, about communication and so forth. But every new moon has the same energy. It's a new beginning, still unconscious for the first 3 days of the cycle. The second phase is after 45 degrees, the moon has moved from the sun, and it is the crescent phase. In the crescent phase, the seed is struggling to send more roots and shoot the first shoot up. And, you know, when you see those two leaves coming up to the surface, this is the same thing with the crescent phase. We're putting out effort in order to sustain that initiation that we did in the new moon. The initiation was unconscious, and now it comes to the consciousness, what it is that we would like. So in the crescent phase, that is 3 days after the new moon, this is the best time to program what it is that you want, make your list, make a vision board. This is it. You have 3 days to do that, and those are the days. Be on time. Use timing to your advantage. If we use timing at the right time, it help us manifest much faster whatever it is that we want. Instead of struggling, we are flowing. The third phase is the first quarter square, or the first quarter phase. And that's happening when the moon have traveled 90 degrees away from the sun. So if this was a new moon, it traveled to the first quarter phase. And usually this phase is characterized by action. The square requires us to take action. So it's not enough to set an intention. It's not enough to program and know what it is that we want and make a vision board. We also have to take an action and show the world, show the universe, show ourselves that we are serious and we are going to create something that is physical, that is of this earth, that is progressing forward and becoming. Whenever we have a first quarter moon, we are required to create some sort of an action and move forward. Those are 3 days of taking action. The sign that the first quarter will happen in will signify what kind of an action do we require to take, what kind of an action is beneficial to propel us forward. The fourth phase is the gibbous moon. The moon is continuing to wax and it's growing and it's becoming fuller towards the full moon. And in the gibbous stage, it is looking backwards at the structure we are building and it is analyzing if it is a good structure, if whatever we bring forth is good. It is analyzing if we can improve on whatever it is that we're building. And it is wanting to perfect the structure that we are building. It's just like the plant when it is starting to bud and all those little buds are coming out. And there is a promise in those buds that the plant will fruit and bring fruits. And the same with us. There is a promise of something that is becoming. This is happening 3 days before the full moon. It's called the gibbous phase. The next phase is the full moon. What is a full moon? The full moon is the stage where we can see what it is that we have been building. Our soul had initiated in the new moon something that kept on growing. We went through stages. We struggled. We programmed. We created some action. We perfected what it is that we've built. And now we can see. Now the soul, our soul, is ready to receive outside input from others because it is ready to give our creation outside. It's the time of illumination, and we can see what it is that we are building, what it is that we are creating, and how can we share it with others? Because this is the purpose of our life, to share with others what it is that we created. Just like the plant, this is the stage where the plant has bloomed, the plant has grown and created fruits, and now the fruits are ready to be shared. It's the same thing with the full moon. The next stage is the disseminating moon. 3 days after the moon is full, the disseminating moon comes into play. It's when we have fruits on the tree and we're sharing them. In the disseminating moon phase, we are always sharing with others what it is that we have learned, our knowledge, what have we done, what can we tell others about our cycle, about our purpose. It's all about purpose. We're doing things with purpose. And in the full moon, we can see what our purpose is. What is our meaning? Once we share it with others, we get extra meaning. We are fulfilled to give our meanings to others. So that's the disseminating phase. The next phase is the third quarter. It's when the moon have traveled 270 degrees away from the sun. We have 3 days of the third quarter, which called crisis in consciousness. It is when our soul has traveled enough. We created fruits. We gave them to others. We discussed what it is. And now we have to let go of the old cycle and start preparing for a new cycle. Whenever we let go of old cycles, we let go of limiting beliefs, we let go of things that we don't need anymore, and we have to contemplate what served us well and what didn't. What do we want to take to the future and what we don't want to? What are we planning to take to the future? The moon is losing its light on the third quarter phase and is getting ready to shed, to give away the energy. So in that particular moment in time, the astrological sign that the third moon is occurring at will signify what kind of realizations and understanding, what kind of epiphanies we are getting at the third quarter moon. The last phase of the cycle is called the balsamic moon. The balsamic moon is when the moon is just 45 degrees behind the sun. And with this balsamic moon, the moon has to give away. It's diminishing its light. It is that time at the plant cycle where the plant is creating the new seed. The seeds are falling into the ground and are getting covered with the ground in order to provide the new plants for the new cycle. The same goes with us. We are letting go of what is not useful anymore, of what we don't need anymore. It's time to regenerate. It's time to shed off many things, let go. It's time for healing. It's time to go inward and unconsciously prepare for the new cycle. Our soul wants to regenerate. Our soul had learned a lot from the last cycle. Now it needs to digest and it needs to regenerate. It's time of healing. It's time of hibernation until the next new moon will come with a burst of new energy for the new cycle. This was a short explanation of the lunation cycle. I hope you really liked it because I think when we follow the moon, we follow our natural rhythm. This is part of our natural ways. We have been following the moon since the beginning of humankind. And being aware of the timing and the phases of the moon give us the opportunity to do the right thing at the right time. Just imagine you want to rest in a new moon. It doesn't fit because a new moon is a burst of energy. Resting time come at the gibbous stage. Or just imagine you want to get the illumination and understanding about something that belongs to the full moon phase. It doesn't belong to the first quarter where you have to take action. So you see, when you do things at the right time and you follow the moon and you follow astrology in general, you get more chances to manifest yourself, to actualize yourself in an easier way. Instead of propelling against the energy, you're flowing with the energy. So happy flow, become the best version of yourself today and every day. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel. I love astrology and I love posting new videos all the time. And if you follow me on Instagram, you know I'm doing moon work constantly. So follow Astrology Dome and I'll see you next time.